Now let us get to the reactions of ethers, you know, other than just hydrolysis. What are the reactions which you can see? First reaction is ethers with oxygen, which means in air. So in air, if we react ethers, we usually see this kind of a compound forming. We will get O, O and H. This is known as hydroperoxide. So we usually see hydroperoxides are forming, and hydroperoxides are, you know, explosive in nature. So this is one thing we always need to check while using ethers, if there is any quantity of hydroperoxide formed. If we expose it to air, usually we would see hydroperoxide formed. In simple terms, if we check out the mechanism, if light is supporting in the presence of air, then ethers would undergo radical mechanism by forming this radical and getting HOO dot. This is the way it will form. Now this radical is actually resonance stabilized. Check out. So it can get this as dot here, the double bond character. Alright. So this type of a resonance stabilization helps that radical to stabilize. And as soon as you have these two radicals, they will terminate to give this hydroperoxide. So usually we will see this as a termination step, where you have this radical terminating with HOO dot, and we will get this. All you need to know is what is hydroperoxide and in nature, whether it is explosive or not. That's all information you need to know from reaction with oxygen. Okay. You can write it down. Once I finish that, I'll put that. Now check out if the same thing, instead of oxygen, if you react that with chlorine. In the dark, the reaction is slow and we will see mono substitutions happening. So chlorine will get added again by radical mechanism. So if you keep on adding further chlorine slowly on this alpha position, you would see chlorines get added. But if you expose it to sunlight and in excess amount, you would see all hydrogens will get replaced by chlorine. So we'll get Cl3 thrice, this CCl3 with two chlorines here and two chlorines here. So in short, I can write this as C2Cl5 times O twice. If you add excess of chlorine, this is what you will see. If you add chlorine in dark, monochlorination is observed. Okay. Next thing you would see is how to identify the test whether there is any hydrogen peroxide, hydroperoxide present or not. In ethers, if there is any hydroperoxide, how do we identify that? See, the minute you have an hydroperoxide, which means it has a peroxy linkage here. So this peroxy linkage will act as a mild oxidizing agent. So in case if we treat that with any Fe+2 salt, this Fe+2 salt will convert into Fe+3 in the presence of this peroxide, and then on reaction with thiocyanides, you remember this, it would form a red color, red blood color formation. So FeSCN+2, or if you can write this as SCN thrice as well. Now this gives a red coloration, right? Other than that, one more test by which you can identify the presence of hydroperoxide in ethers is treating that with dilute H2SO4 and then treating with Ki. Same thing can be observed, that OOH in the presence of I- will convert that to I2, which means it is acting like a mild oxidizing agent, converting that I- to I2, and I2 in starch will show blue color. So this confirms that there is a presence of hydroperoxide in ethers. Okay, usually there would be some quantity of hydroperoxide present in ethers, irrespective of how pure you want to take with the ethers form. I hope you guys got that. Make a note of it. Now let us come to the next reaction. This is a reaction with AlCl3, RC double bond OCl in the presence of AlCl3. So basically acylation type, right? So what we can expect is that this AlCl3 will act like a Lewis acid, lone pair on oxygen will donate, which increases the electrophilicity of this carbon, and then the nucleophile can attack. So accordingly the products can be seen. So let me show you the mechanism. So we can expect that RC double bond O Cl, which is in contact with AlCl3, will increase the electrophilicity, thereby this lone pair will attack here and we will get this as RO RCO minus Cl O R dash R dash with positive charge. As soon as this happens, this lone pair will close, Cl minus being a better leaving group will come out and we will get this as RC double bond O O R dash and R dash positive. Now the Cl minus which has left will attack on the less substituted carbon and we will get this as RC double bond O O R dash plus R dash Cl. So that's how the reaction will take place. The alternate reagent which you can take is a ZnCl2 or FeCl3 and heat. So these can also act like alternative Lewis acids so that this reaction can be facilitated. Carbon monoxide. Ethers, when you treat that with carbon monoxide and heat, here also we will get this as an ester formation. But you can get two types of esters here because depends upon what R or R dash you are taking here. Okay. So basically you can see C double bond O here, then empty orbital and a lone pair. This is carbon monoxide. So the lone pair will attack on carbon monoxide here and we will get this as R dash with C double bond O minus charge. Okay. So this, as soon as the minus is there, there would be a migration of group. Now this migration can be done by either of the carbons. We can get this as R dash double bond O. Got it? So we are getting like an ester. So the same migration O R dash C double bond O minus. This migration can also be seen. So we can have R O R dash. This is the most important part. This is pretty much there in our syllabus. So now check it out. Reactions of oxyranes. Especially how the ring opening happens when you have oxyranes, whether it is symmetrical type or an unsymmetrical type, what are the reactions that will take place? Okay. So first let me write the products and I'll go through the mechanism one by one. See, if you have epoxides, this carbon, both this carbon side, will have sufficient positive charge or sufficient electrophilicity. So nucleophiles will attack on that position. To increase the electrophilicity, we can first treat this epoxides or oxyranes with electrophiles like H plus. So if the H plus comes over, the electrophilicity of these two carbons increases more and then water can attack on that. So usually that is what you will see. First we will see that H plus is getting attached here and then H2O will attack as a nucleophile, right? And this will go through an SN2 mechanism and ring opening has been seen and an anti-addition is favored. We will get this. This is what we would get. Sorry. Consider I'm taking this as an isotopic oxygen. So we would get this isotopic oxygen here. When you have symmetrical side on symmetrical carbons on both sides, then it doesn't matter, you know, because either of the side you will get that OH. So it doesn't matter pretty much. Now, next, if you have OH minus is a strong nucleophile. So the attack would be direct, which means OH minus will directly attack on that. Ring opening will take place. So we would pretty much get this as epoxide here. Right? Sorry, pretty much get this as alkoxide, and then on hydrolysis, you will again get that as an alcohol. So these are the diols which are formed. Okay. So in both the cases, you will get the same product. Okay. So we are getting the same product here. As long as there is a symmetrical epoxide, you will always get the same product with water in acidic medium or basic medium. Now, lithium aluminium hydride is a strong nucleophile as well. So that will attack first and later hydrolysis has been done. So from now onwards, I'm directly writing the products and all these mechanisms are done by SN2 only. So we'll get this OH and star. NaBH4, if you compare epoxide's electrophilicity, that is not sufficient to directly make sure BH4 minus can react. So BH4 minus does not have sufficient nucleophilicity to attack on that carbon. So you will not see reaction with NaBH4. Next, RLi. If you treat this RLi, R minus is a very, very strong base and strong nucleophile. So that can easily attack here and we can get a product like this. So R and OH. Okay. Next, check out with KSH. SH minus is also a strong nucleophile. So that would attack first, later second step is hydrolysis. So we will get this. This is the star which I am writing here. CH3C triple bond minus is also a strong nucleophile. It will attack first. So we'll get this as CH3C triple bond C connected with carbon and then OH. Grignard's reagent Me minus is also a very strong nucleophile. So we can expect that to react first. So we'll get this as OH. Star oxygen here. MeO minus is also a very strong nucleophile, so we can expect that to be MeO minus attacking here with OH. So I guess you understood that except in this acidic medium, in rest all the cases the attack is the first nucleophile and then hydrolysis happening. Okay, so all are SN2 reactions. Got it? That this OH minus, LaH, RLi, SH minus, acetyl, Grignard's, alkoxide, these are all very strong nucleophiles. Strong nucleophiles always prefer to give SN2 reactions. And if they are trying to give SN2 reactions, sorry, they will look over for two criteria. One, how much electrophilic carbon it is. Second, how much crowding it has. Least the crowding, better SN2 is favored, right? And more the electrophilic nature, more is the SN2 favored. So on these two cases, on these two bases, we can say that we can choose the regioselectivity of the reactions in case of unsymmetrical epoxides. Okay. So I'm categorizing them into three cases. Case one, when you have strong nucleophiles or strong basic nature. So when you have strong basic or strong nucleophilic nature, the attack would be on the least substituted side. The attack would always be on the least substituted side, which means suppose if you check out here, this carbon is more substituted, this carbon is less substituted, and lithium aluminium hydride is a strong nucleophile. So this would definitely attack here and that's how the product will be formed. Okay, just to showcase the mechanism, you can check out this minus is attacking here, a ring open will happen from this end, and we would get this as H, and here we'll get this as O minus, and on hydrolysis we will get this alcohol, and this H is the one which is present here, right? I hope all of you got this. So basically we are trying to learn about regioselectivity, dividing them into three cases. Case one, where you have, you know, one alkyl group making it an unsymmetrical epoxide and reacting with strong nucleophiles, then the attack will always happen at the less substituted side. Second case, what I'm taking is weak nucleophiles, you know, in acidic medium like water and H plus, like methanol and H plus, or methanol and HCl. We can take RCOOH H plus, like this. In case if you take this weak nucleophiles here on the same unsymmetrical case, now also what has been found that the major product is still the case where there is less substituted. Got it? This is a very important case where we usually make mistakes, so check it out. So if the carbon is, one side is, it is 1 degree, the other side it is 2 degree, then also regular SN2 is most favored, and this would come as almost 62 to 64%, which means if you check out the mechanism here, first the lone pair will attack on H plus, it will get this OH form, and H2O could attack on both the sides because it is weak nucleophile, right? But it is still favoring on the less substituted side because the electrophilicity on both the sides is still almost comparable. This side, the electrophilicity of carbon, this side, the electrophilicity of carbon is still comparable. Hence, water would choose the direction where there is less substitution. Okay. So, what kind of a product we will have now? So, we will have this OH and HO here, which is substituted, and this is the methyl which is present. This is methyl, sorry. Okay. So, please remember that if there is only single methyl group, okay, not even ethyl, if you have methyl group, then water is still preferring onto the side where there is less substitution. Water, or it could be methanol, it could be RCOH, any weak nucleophiles. See the third case. Third case is a important case where we will see the changes coming here now. Okay. So if one of the side is tertiary, which means it has two alkyl groups here, correct? Then the minute we had H plus, it almost forms like a carbocation here, got it? So the minute we add an H plus on that, there would be a buildup of charge on both the carbons, and this side the positive charge would be much more because it is more stabilized there. There are alkyl groups that can stabilize. So that's why delta positive, now the electronic effect or the electrophilicity of this carbon would be more. So remember that now emphasis is all on this carbon. So this carbon's electrophilicity increases as soon as you add some electrophile on oxygen. So see the mechanism now. First, as soon as you add on H plus, got it? So this oxonium ion is formed, and that will have sufficient delta positive on this carbon. Because it has sufficient delta positive, any nucleophile that attacks here, so like I minus, if it attacks, this has been shown to attack on this carbon side, correct? So if you see the transition state, it would be something like this. I would come here, right? So this has delta positive, this is delta positive, this is coming with delta negative. Sorry. So finally the product that will form will be OH and I. Okay. So imagine if iodine itself can give this as a major product, water in fact give 99% only on this side. Water, methanol, acids has been found to give 99% of their product on this more substituted carbon side. Okay, so this is an important case. So which tells us to understand that if there is any stabilizing group which is present on this carbon, not just this two methyl groups, it may so happen there is a benzyl group also. Benzyl group will also form a stable carbocation. So if it is a benzylic position also, the nucleophiles will attack it this side rather than this side. Methanol is a weak nucleophile in acidic medium, so obviously first protonation will take place here, then methanol will attack here this side. So let me write the final product. So we would get OME attached here with OH group here. Suppose if this is isotopic, this would be the isotopic oxygen. Same way, if you have a phenyl group is stabilizing this carbocation formation there. So in this you have first and second cases. This is an unsymmetrical epoxide, one side there is a methyl group. Here you know that first protonation will take place, but still SN2, regular SN2 is only favored. So think about it, write the products. So I'm guessing all of you must have got this. Check your answers. Anyone has a doubt can ask me. Check. When epoxide is acting like an electrophile, especially electrophilic aromatic substitution reactions are seen, right, are observed, then how does that happen? Let us see. In the presence of AlCl3, obviously the lone pair on oxygen, you know, will attack on aluminium, increases the electrophilicity of these carbons. So that's when the pi will attack on the electrophilic side here. So we would get this connection as soon as this attacks, this bond will break and we'll have OACl3 minus, there is H plus here, right? So this bond will get back to form the aromatic ring here, and we'll get this as OH plus AlCl3. So simple electrophilic aromatic substitution. I'm sure you may have seen this during the benzene, how ES happens on epoxides. The same thing can be observed even if there is an unsymmetrical epoxide here. So if there is one methyl or two methyl groups on this side, then also it is absurd, but pi would always attack on, you know, more substituted carbon, because here electrophilic part is more important. It is not the stereo part which is important. More delta positive charge is important here. So therefore, the attack would be always on the more substituted side. So accordingly, you can check out what is the product. So you can get a product like this with OH, and here we'll get a product OH with two methyl groups. Make a note. So just I'll put it as a note that benzene attacks on at more substituted carbon. Just like how we have seen earlier, when you have an unsymmetrical epoxide, the same unsymmetrical epoxide with two methyl groups this time, got it? And you have to fill the same places here, practice that. Now you know the difference, like, you know, in case if we use acidic medium like these two, you can check out, these two are in acidic medium, then the attack would be on the more substitution side. If they are directly treated with strong nucleophiles, then there is no problem. They will always hit on this carbon. So if you take methoxide, it will attack here. OH minus attacks here. Grignard's, it will attack here. LH attacks here. SH minus this. There is no reaction with this. Ammonia, even ammonia is a strong nucleophile, it will attack here. So accordingly, write the products. These are specific reactions which you may have already come across alkenes So in case if we react that with triphenyl phosphine with an unsymmetrical alkyne here, so PPH3 is a strong nucleophile, so and it is not in acidic medium, so attack would be here and cleavage of epoxide is seen. So we will have this as O minus with this group with PPH3 plus. Now as soon as this is, as soon as we see this, you can see by, because it is a single bond here, O minus will rotate towards the PPH3 plus, and this O minus will attack on phosphorus, and as it attacks there would be a bond formation here, and you would see this kind of a bond is formed with O and phosphorus, and it has three phenyl groups here. So you remember this is phosphatane, and then bond will break here. This bond will break here. The motivation for this reaction is the strong P double bond O bond. So it will break this way so that it can get PPH3 with double bond O and an alkene like this. This alkene is formed. Okay. Note that. Next, you can see intramolecular reaction happening here. If you have MeO minus, which is a strong nucleophile, that would attack on the less substituted side, open the ring, which means cleave the ring, and generates this nucleophile, which will again attack on iodine, because iodine is a better leaving group there. So, which means first MeO minus will attack on this carbon, this bond will undergo cleavage. So, we'll have MeO attached this way, where you have O minus, which is connected with I here. So, this O minus will attack this I. So, internal SN2 is happening here. So, finally, we will get this as MeO connected here with this group having O bond formation here. Correct. So, this will be the final product. So, MeO. And this will be the final product. So possibly I have discussed all the cases in ethers, which is there for your syllabus. So you have to go through that each and every case, check out carefully. Last thing, I have added epoxides like what we have did it concentrated HI and concentrated HI excess, okay, which means cold concentrated HI or hot concentrated HI, similar cases. So, for all these three cases, 1, 2, 3, with symmetrical, unsymmetrical, you know, with 2-2 alkyl groups, what are the products you would try out on your own? This has more electrophilic character. This has more electrophilic.
I minus is better leaving group.
Because of the, yes, better, because of the strain it has, right? Okay, this bond is very weak. Carbon single bond oxygen is much stronger compared to that of what you will experience in epoxides. Okay.
So it becomes
better. Yes. Now let's quickly go through anisole, because this is all the repeated reactions once again from benzene, same reactions all together. So we'll just quickly go through that. So give the heading as reactions of anisole. Preparation wise, we have already seen by Williamson synthesis, we can get anisoles. IUPAC name is methoxybenzene. Now, in this OME, you know, is a strong donating group here. So, it will activate ortho and para positions for electrophiles to approach. So, if you are treating that with Br2, right, in acidic solution, we will get this as OH or OME. Now, if you compare the characteristic of OME with respect to OH, OH is much more donating. OME, because the minus effect, if you check out, OME has more minus effect compared to that of OH. Okay. So, overall, if you see, OH is more donating as compared to that of OME. So unlike OH, that means in phenols you will see bromine attacks at all the positions, which does not happen with methoxybenzene. So it will attack at ortho as well as para position only. But if you add it in excess, same bromine, if you add it in excess, the same thing, then we can observe that it can give all ortho para completely electrophiled by bromine. Okay. Next reaction you can check out. If you treat that with concentrated HNO3 and concentrated H2SO4, that is nitration. So same thing we can see here, OME getting nitrated on ortho and para position in O2. Next is Friedel-Crafts alkylation. Okay, OH relatively gets poor yield, but OME will give sufficient yield in Friedel-Crafts reactions. So you can see OME CH3, OME CH3. So this is FC reaction or FC alkylation. Same way here, this is acylation step. So we would get this as OME COCH3, OME COCH3. This is FC acylation. So it does give Friedel-Crafts reactions. Right. So this one is little important here. You check out. If you take diazonium salt, this is benzene diazonium salt, BDC. Right. And since there is sufficient ortho para direct ring when it comes to OCH3, we may expect that from the para position or from the ortho position, it will attack on the N plus, which is what usually OH, if there is OH, it will do the same thing. From ortho position or from the para position, it will attack diazonium salt as an electrophile. Okay. But this reaction is not seen with anisole, because anisole is not as sufficiently activating as compared to that of OH or NH2. So OH or NH2 are very strongly activating, hence they would give this reaction, but not anisole. See, one thing, benzene diazonium salt is not a very strong electrophile, right? So when it comes to this, it is under resonance stabilized here. So this way we have plus charge, correct? So it is resonance stabilized here. So that means this positive charge is moving throughout this ring. So it is not completely isolated positive charge, correct? So we can say that benzene diazonium salt is not a very strong electrophile. But you can make it a strong electrophile if you keep some withdrawing groups like NO2. So if you position some NO2 and ortho and para position, they will in fact pull the electron density towards that and increase the delta positive on nitrogen. So this positive charge will be sufficiently available, then the reaction will take place. Okay. Then from this para position, you can see from this para position, it will attack the diazonium salt here, and we will get this kind of a product, OME, okay, with N, double bond N, this group NO2 and NO2 here. Okay, this type of a reaction where benzene diazonium salt is been coupled by another benzene ring, that is called coupling reaction or diazocoupling reaction. So we can see coupling reaction is happening. Okay, this N double bond N, wherever there is present between two methyl groups, it will always be colored. So it will always give colored dyes the solution, whether it is with OH, whether it is with NH2, even if it is with OCH3, but only in this case. Next, see the reaction, Claisen's rearrangement. Claisen's rearrangement is, allyl epoxides, allyl anisole formation here, so which will get rearranged on heating. Got it. So you will get a product like this. We'll get a phenol by allyl substitution. And this time the carbon 14, which is here, will be formed on this side. Okay. If you just look over the mechanism, how it works, this pi bond will act like a nucleophilic site, attacks on the electrophile, and this pi will shift here, correct? The bond will break here to get oxygen as a O minus charge on it. So we will get this as O minus, right? And this pi has shifted here with double bond here. There is hydrogen also present here. With this positive charge here. So it retains the aromaticity by taking away that H plus, and we will get this as OH, double bond, double bond, double bond here, and this one, oh sorry, this one, connection here like this. So you can see carbon 14, which was here, that got actually connected. So major product will always be from this end. Okay. So in 88% of the product would be this only. Okay. So some other product, as in this carbon can also get attached here after breaking. Correct. So small percentage of that has been observed. But if at all we have both the ortho positions closed by some methyl already, and then you are heating, still you will get the product, but this time you will get only para product. So which means we will have this alkyl groups, then OH would be here and allyl group would be formed here. Now what we are getting currently here, this could be carbon 14, this could be that carbon 14 which you have, as well as carbon 14 can be attached here as well. Preferable mechanism could be that the lone pair will attack here, this pi will shift, this pi will shift here as a, and it will give a minus charge there. So we can get this as a double bond O, this, and we'll get minus here, and as soon as this comes, oxygen will take away its electrons from this carbon, making an allyl carbocation available. So carbocation will be available. So this allyl carbocation will be resonance stabilized on both the sides, right? So that's why you can see carbon 14, which is here, both side can attack. So you will get these two products. So I'm not writing the products again. So after attacking on that, you can get these two products. Make a note of that.